Hello and welcome back to Legend of Zelda The Wind Waker. In this episode, we are finally going to leave Windfall Island and actually work our way towards the first dungeon in the game. To do that, we're going to head towards Dragon Roost Island. Now, this is the first time that we've actually gotten the sail, the Great Sea. We have the sail now that we got on Windfall Island. We got that a couple of videos ago before we went after all those heart pieces, joy pendants, and other side quest items. Now, what we need to do is we need to head east. Now, sailing in this game is not really that difficult, but it can be confusing for people who are new to it. The compass is kind of inverted. To me, the red looks like the way you need to point, but in fact, it's like the opposite. You need the blue side to point to where you want to go, so it's pointing east. So that's where we're going to head, and that's where Dragon Roost Island. That's actually the island that's all the way out there in the horizon. Now, if this audio quality sucks, I apologize. I am using a different mic than usual. I've lost my headset, so I do apologize for that. But before we actually head into Windfall, or Dragon Roost Island, it is, I'm going to take a quick detour to find ourselves a heart piece. Seems the heart pieces are all over this area, which is good because I'm trying to 100% this game. So the first thing we're going to do is just kind of dock right here at this island that we kind of come to right along the way. Now that the dock, just put your sail away by pressing A, and then you can just like kind of swim up to shore. Now, it's been a while since I've played this, but I know there's a heart piece, an entrance to a heart piece somewhere on this. For some reason, there's a hole somewhere to get in underneath somewhere. I'm not quite sure, so I'm just going to kind of slash around a little bit. This island's got these weird frog things all over. I'm not sure what they're supposed to be. And we've also got this giant half-sphere site, like, thing right there that glows. It's like a cracked eggshell that glows where it's cracked. That's how I describe it. Not really sure what it's supposed to be, but that's what it looks like to me. Anyways, what I'm starting to think there's not a hole that's actually underneath the grass, and you know what, that actually makes sense. Now that I think about it, the hole is not actually in the grass. I think you crawl into this egg. Wait, there's the hole right there. All right. So yeah, you just crawl into the egg and put your equipment away, and you can just crawl right in and drop down the hole. That's where the hole is. I knew there's a hole somewhere. Alright, so this just takes you to an underground cavern, and there's a lot of red choo-choos, which are a new item, or enemy per se, to the Wind Waker. And when you kill them, you get this new item, red choo jelly, and there's different choo-choos in the game. They drop different colored goo based on what color those are. Obviously red are going to drop red, and they can be used to make a variety of potions and stuff like that. So, I mean, I won't really be using them all that often, but I will collect them when I kill them. So, alright, I'm just gonna grab some rupees while I'm in here. And if you go all the way here and open this chest, we are going to get ourselves a heart piece, which is perfect. Alright, cool. Three so far, I need one more, and I'll be styling. Anyways, now that we're done in here, we just proceed back out, if I can find my way back out. There's a lot of other paths you can take inside of this cavern, which will get you lost. There's like a gravel area, there's an area we can use bombs at, like right there to proceed, and there's actually, I think this is the way we go straight, and we also went past a bombable area on the way in earlier, so we might be returning here later on in the game. In the meantime, we're just gonna go ahead and exit, and we're going to do one last thing before we proceed to Dragon Roost Island. And that is get ourselves a treasure map. It's right here next to this island, so we may as well stop and take some time and get it. If you see that boat right there, not too far away, That's what we're going to be heading over towards, just talking to those guys. Alright, so let's. Just get straight up to him, ram yourself into him, that works. I don't remember if I need to climb up on here to talk to him. It doesn't seem that way. So we're gonna try and talk to him from the boat before I drown. Anyways. Okay, so back into the King of Red Lions and target. Come on, let me target him. Here we go. And now you can talk. Now these guys are fellow treasure divers. They got their diving mask and everything. Kind of a weird group of people. And they're going to give us this treasure chart, which we really can't use right now. We need the claw shot to dig up treasure. And we don't have that at the moment, so for now we're just going to put this in our inventory and we'll take a look at that later on in the game. Yeah, with the grappling hook is what we're going to need, so. With that done, I'm going to go ahead and proceed to Dragon Roost Island. And in the next video, we'll actually explore the island a bit and work our way into the cavern. And the rest of this video is pretty much just a straight shot, sail in. There's other things you can do on the Great Sea at the moment if you really want to. If you see those rafts, you should stop at them and kill the pink hobgoblins, and you'll get joy pendants. Now, joy pendants aren't really that useful in this game, so I'm going to kind of just leave them. There's so many places to get joy pendants at that I'm not going to actually stop to kill those guys and get them. But once we get to Dragon Roost Island, we are going to acquire the Wind Waker, from which this game is named, obviously, and learn how to play the basic operations of it, which will be coming up here soon. Alright. Cool. Now this is another great island in this game. I love the larger islands, Outset, Windfall, and Dragon Roost. They're some of my favorite regions in the entire Zelda series, so we're going to have some fun here. Anyways, go ahead and dock. And like Ocarina of Time, we're going to be collecting kind of stones, per se, are based off of the three sacred goddesses, Din, Naru, and Feror. But before we proceed, as I said, we're going to get this Wind Waker. Playing the Wind Waker is very simple. He's going to give us a brief tutorial here. I really don't need to talk you guys through it. There's three different times, 3-4, 4-4, 6-4, and you just point your C stick and keep it to the beat, and that's pretty much it. Pretty basic. So I'm going to just leave it with that. Stay tuned for next video where we explore Dragon Roost Island. Should be a good one, so don't forget to subscribe, stay tuned, and don't forget to comment and like the video. Thanks everybody. Thank you.